Ciao friends! We are approaching the end of 2024 and it's time for our annual review through the DAX world. What happened in 2024? Let's start with visual calculations. It's a DAX feature only available in Power BI and not in Excel to write calculations that are based on the data available in a visual. It is simpler to create running totals and comparisons, but these calculations cannot be published in the model or shared between different visuals. Visual calculations introduce the 12 new DAX functions, including moving average and running sum. The feature is still in preview. Microsoft also added other 14 new info functions to simplify access to data management views, which are not needed if you have access to Bravo, DAX Studio, or Tabular Editor. Now, let's talk about SQLBI. We completed the Optimizing DAX video course, adding the sections that were missing in the first release in 2023. This course is absolutely up to date. If you use Direct Lake, just use the same content that exists for Vertibug. We also published the Optimizing DAX book, also known as The Brick. Remember, if you register for the video course, you receive a PDF copy of the book, but you can also buy the physical book on its own. And you can buy the book even if you don't register for the video course. It's an expensive book, we know, but after reading it, you can use the book for upper body workouts and for holding heavy doors open. This year, Kurt Buhler joined the SQLBI team. Kurt is currently focused on data visualization, and you can already read several articles and videos written by Kurt, but there is more to come in 2025. This year, we also contributed to the DAX Optimizer release. DAX Optimizer is a commercial tool for finding bottlenecks in the DAX code of semantic models in Power BI and Fabric. The tool is also integrated with Tabular Editor 3, and a license for one model is included in the Tabular Editor Enterprise licenses. As always, we will continue to produce free articles and videos every other week. Speaking of videos, our YouTube channel surpassed 100,000 subscribers. Actually, we are over 110,000 now. Thank you for your support. So, what is coming in 2025? Microsoft announced user-defined functions in DAX. We call them UDF. In other words, you will be able to write calculations in a function and reuse that function in different measures without having to copy and paste the code. We hope that they will be released in 2025 because we want to include user-defined function in the third edition of the Definitive Guide to DAX. We're already writing it, but we have to wait the public preview of all the new features. If you see a publishing date, it's not reliable. Our plan is simple. Wait for Microsoft to show features in public preview, deliver the book to the publisher, wait for the distribution. We hope this will happen in 2025, but it depends on many moving parts. Expect new content from Alberto, Kurt, and me. As usual, I would like to say more, but no spoilers. Something new is coming in the first half of 2025, but I cannot say more. Last but not least, while we will continue to incrementally improve in DAX Optimizer, expect some news about free tools. Spoilers? Well, there is already a first beta of a command line visualization of the VPAX files, but you can expect much more. On behalf of everyone at SQLBI, I wish you a great 2025 and enjoy DAX!
Are you ready?
So, repeat again. The row context iterates and the filter context filters.
The row context filters and the filter context iterates. How was that?
Let's try again. So the filter context filters and the row context iterates. Okay?
The filter context iterates and the row context filters. How about that?
I think that you will not graduate this year.
Oh no, that's disappointing. I'll keep trying and do better next time.
Yeah.